Hi everybody, this is Morgan C. and I'm reporting for Tranny Star Galactica. This week's topic was supplied by Jenny, and it asks us to talk about somebody in the trans community who was a positive influence on your life. Had a hard time choosing just one, and I felt like I have to go like kind of historical on it, because I am surrounded by amazing people here in Montreal and both and on the internet. And I feel like if I just start listing all these people who are currently influencing me a lot, the list might just keep going on forever. So I'm gonna like wheel it back to historical levels of like 8-9 years ago, when I was considering whether or not I was trans. and I was probably 18 or 19. It was the summertime. It was Gay Pride Month. And Showcase is a channel in Canada. And it's like basically the Canadian version of Showtime. Late at night they have sexy shows. During the Pride Month, they had a bunch of different marathons for stuff, and they had a marathon for the British Queers Folk, and I watched that whole series, and I thought that was really nice. At the time, I guess I'm not sure how it stands up for now, but it also had it showed a marathon of Kink. So Kink was a documentary show that followed around people throughout different alternative sex scenes and BDSM lifestyles in Canada, and each season was in a different city. The second season of the show was based in Toronto, and it featured prominently Nina Arsenault, who is an amazing trans woman. I admit that I kind of fell in love with her right away, not just because she's beautiful, but it was kind of one of the first times that I'd seen, like, a trans woman as, like, a real person. And that sounds awful to say, but I mean, like, in media representation, there wasn't a lot going on for me in the positive. But, you know, the show just was like a reality TV show or whatever, or a documentary. And it just kind of followed her around from doing her day-to-day things and kind of going from her different jobs and stuff like that. And it's like made it seem much more realistic that trans people exist and all that. And up until that point, I guess the prominent media that I'd seen incredibly attractive trans women in was porn. So it's kind of like, it was always kind of confusing how you get from where I was to, you know, fucking. she just, you know, was a positive example. And one at a time when I really needed it. And I really had been struggling throughout high school about what to do about this. And, you know, she kind of alleviated my fears. And to a point where I almost immediately, well, like, within a couple of days of watching this season of the show, that I came out to my mom and, you know, wanted to start doing something about this. And that's a whole other debacle I can get into. But, I don't know. Yeah, she just provided, at the time, positive checkpoint, reference points for who I could be if I wanted to. 8 years later, I look back and I'm like, you know, I can see where my path diverges from mine and hers, but she's still like an amazing person, and she's gone into like performance art and theater, and she does a one-woman show called The Silicone Diaries, which talks a lot. I have never seen it. It came to Montreal, but I had gone home for Christmas, so I missed it, which sucks. Yeah, The Silicone Diaries, I guess, is kind of a dramatic presentation of her journey through like almost record-setting plastic surgery procedures. I don't know if that's true, that there's a record or not, But she had a lot of them, I guess. Anyway, you should check out her website. I'll put the link below. It's full of awesome documentation and media and photography and writing and all sorts of stuff that she's doing. And just kind of, it blows me away. Obviously our paths of aesthetic beauty have diverged quite a bit. But I still think, yeah, she's fucking stunning. And a lot of her work talks about that specific look, and it's kind of I guess dating her as early 2000s aesthetic, this kind of plastic surgery aesthetic, which is interesting. I don't have one the money or the energy or interest in going that direction, but I still find her deeply fascinating. So. Another person who has been kind of quite a positive influence on me, or at least set me on this kind of track of vlogging or something, is Freshly Charles, who's kind of the first YouTuber of trans vlogger that I got into. I always found that the way that they take their life experiences and kind of transform them into these stories that are like both conceptually interesting and funny, and I don't know, the way they conceptualize queerness makes it just sound interesting to me. I don't know. I can't exactly figure it out, and I wish I could exactly what appeals to me, because you know, I would prefer to be more well-spoken, better at presenting my information in a way that sounds intelligent and is fun. So yeah, they kind of influenced me to get on the path of vlogging once I like decided that I was going to start transitioning. And two, they would do videos with friends, and introduced me to Red Durkin, who's really funny and awesome. And I really liked her channel. And she doesn't really make videos as much anymore, I don't think. But she's working for this website called Pretty Queer. I'll put a link below, and I'll put a link to all their channels, too. But then Red Durkin mentioned Trans Star Galactica in a video, and then I found this channel, which is neat. So there's a little chain. And then, yeah, now that's where I am, which is pretty fucking awesome, as it turns out. Like, I was going to end off the video by sharing a few kind of personal anecdotes, maybe not, about people in my real life who kind of just by being there were positive influences, and I could visualize myself being part of, I guess, the queer community of Montreal. But I feel like I have the actual opportunity to share my kudos with these people on more personal levels, and I feel like maybe doing it to a third party via the video YouTubes maybe seems a bit impersonal and actually kind of maybe a bit odd. So I'm gonna resist the urge to share personal stuff about other people and just tell them personally that I really respect them and find other ways maybe just to promote and encourage my friends. That makes sense? Yeah, I think so. Okay, so yeah, that's how I'm gonna end my video. Thank you very much for listening, and I'll see you next Tuesday. Okay, goodbye.